Act 3. Act 3, Scene 1. Hero tells her servant Margaret to fetch Beatrice and tells her that she overheard Hero and Ursula gossiping about Beatrice in the orchard. Hero then orders Ursula to talk about Benedict as if he were madly in love with Beatrice. She agrees and they wait until they see Beatrice hide herself in the orchard before walking towards the hiding spot. They arrive where Beatrice is hiding and Hero informs Ursula that Benedict is madly in love with Beatrice, but that she will never tell Beatrice because she is afraid her cousin would only ridicule Benedict. Ursula agrees and Hero then mentions that Beatrice is so sharp-tongued that she often finds faults in men that are not really there. Ursula then praises Benedict as a man, saying he is one of the best men in Italy and would be an excellent match for Beatrice. After they leave, Beatrice steps forward and comments that rather than be condemned for her pride and scorn, she will requite Benedict's love and marry him. Now there is a direct conversation happening between Ursula and Hero and they are trying to convince each other for Beatrice and Benedict's love. Now Beatrice has eventually fallen in love with Benedict and Ursula is trying to explain that Beatrice is so sharp-tongued that she keeps condemning and finding faults in men. But eventually we understand by the end of this that Beatrice really loves Benedict and wants to marry him. Act 3, Scene 2. Claudia, Don Pedro and Leonardo find Benedict to be acting sadder than usual, making fun of him as if he's in love. He does not deny their charge but finally asks Leonardo if he could have a word with him in private. Don Pedro tells Claudia that Benedict must want to discuss Beatrice with Leonardo. Don John arrives and informs Claudia and Don Pedro that Hero is unfaithful. He offers to prove it to them, telling them to go with him that night and look into Hero's chamber window. Claudia states that if he sees any reason not to wed Hero that night, he will shame her in the church before the wedding ceremony the next day. Don Pedro supports him and they promise to meet Don John that very night. Act 3, Scene 3. Dogberry and Verges, both fools in charge of the watchmen, get one of their men and make them the constable of the watch for the night. Now he agrees but asks what he should do if he orders a man to stop and the man refuses. Dogberry tells him to ignore the man and good riddance of a knave because they can only stop loyal subjects of the prince. Verges then orders the man to keep silence throughout the town. They leave the man to his job as constable and Dogberry orders him to wake him up only if something important comes up. Borachio and Conard arrive and accidentally stand within hearing distance of the watchman whom Dogberry appointed constable. Borachio tells Conard that he earned 1,000 ducats from Don John that night because he wooed Margaret in Hero's room and called her Hero. Meanwhile, Don John had brought Don Pedro and Claudia to Orchard where they watched this whole scene and became convinced that Hero was committing infidelity. One of the night watchmen, having overheard the story, arrests Borachio and Conard for willingly. They agree to go peacefully and are taken to be judicially interrogated. Act 3, Scene 4. Hero is getting dressed by Margaret for her wedding that day. Now she sends Ursula to fetch Beatrice, who arrives but has lost her witnesses and has also caught a cold. Margaret makes severely sexually explicit puns before mentioning to Beatrice that Benedict is now in love. Margaret then implies that perhaps Beatrice will someday decide to fall in love, much the Benedict has. Ursula interrupts her and informs Hero that the men are all gathered to take her to the church. Act 3, Scene 5. Dogberry has gone to Leonardo to inform him that two suspicious men were arrested that very night before, which is actually mentioned in Act 3, Scene 3. He asks Leonardo to examine the men, but since the wedding is that day, Leonardo refuses and orders Dogberry to conduct the examination all by himself because he is busy in following the functions of Act 3, Scene 4. Dogberry orders Burgess to bring one of his men who knows how to write so that they can write down the entire examination and bring it to Leonardo.